Hello Python students. In last lecture, we saw various concepts related to strings like concatenation, indexing and slicing. In this lecture, we will see few more concepts related to strings. And the first concept is called replication. Let's declare one variable s as a string and the value is good. Print. So far we have seen what happens when we use a plus operator or a minus operator with string. Now we will see what happens if we use multiplication operator with string s star 5. So what you think, what should be the output of this particular Python program? Will it encounter an error or will it print something? Let's try it. It prints the string 5 times one after the another, which means it is like a concatenation operator where the same string is concatenated with itself 5 times. Let's take it one step further. Instead of s, if we make it s of 0, now what will be the output? Let's see. 5 times the letter g, because s of 0 is g. This particular feature of string data type is called as replication, where a string or a character from a string replicates itself based on the number with which it is multiplied by. Now the next string property is string comparison. Let's write one small piece of code. X is equal to India, print X equal to India, and print X equal to India, but over here this I is small. So the question is, what will be the output of this kind of comparison? A letter being capital or small, does that make any difference, or still it will consider the string India as same, which is like variable X? Let's execute the code. First it's true, obviously, because we have I as capital, but in second case it is false, which means a single letter change from capital to small letter is considered as not equal. Therefore, X equal to India with small I is resulting into false. Let's see some more examples where a string comparison is happening. Print apple greater than 1 and print 4 less than 10. What do you think? What will be the output of such string comparison? First, even is it possible to compare strings like this, or will it result into an error? Let's figure out. There is no error. It shows some output, false and true. Now let's see why false and true. First, when we compare apple greater than 1, it says false. If you see, the string apple is longer or has more characters than the string 1. Still, it is not greater. Similarly, in second case, when we compare 4 less than 10, it says true. But we know 4 is not less than 10. But that is true when we compare 4 and 10 as integers. Here, the word 4 and 10 are strings. Hence, the comparison operator works in a different manner. Let's see how these comparison operators greater than and equal to works with strings. A computer starts the comparison process character by character, as in the zeroth letter of first string, which is A in this case, will be compared against the zeroth letter of second string, which is O in this case. That means a computer will compare whether A is greater than O. As we know, in alphabetical order, A comes before O, which means A is not greater than O. because of that, it results into false. Similarly, in second case, the letter F is less than T because the letter F comes before letter T in an alphabetical order. Because of that, it says true. Now you must be thinking, what happens if first letters are equal? Let's try to have one example where the first letter is equal and see what happens next. Print AB less than AZ. In this case, the first letter A is equal, but the second letter B and Z are different. Similarly, in second print statement, first couple of letters are same. In fact, all the letters from second string are exactly identical with all initial letters from first string except the last one character. Let's see what output this particular string comparison gives us. It says true followed by false, which means AB is less than AZ. This is happening because when first character is equal, computer moves to the next character, which is B and Z. As B comes before Z in alphabetical order, it says true. Now, in case of second print statement, the first letter, as in the zeroth letter of first string, which is A, which is matching to the zeroth letter of second string, same the second letter, which is B, next letter C, next letter D, and then next letter E. All these letters are matching. In first case, after E, there is one letter, which is F. But on the right hand side of that less than operator, there is no letter to compare after E. Because of that, computer end up comparing F with nothing. And due to that, the output is false. Because F cannot be less than nothing. Next string concept is string indexing. But in this lecture, we will see a different kind of string indexing called as negative indexing. Let's declare one string, S is equal to Python, print S of 0, S of 1, S of 2, and so on. And the output is P, Y, T, H, O, N, as expected. This is something we have already done. What if we do something different this time? Instead of giving these indexes 0, 1, 2, and so on, can we give negative numbers? For example, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. What do you think? What will be the output of this particular Python program? Can we even access minus 1 letter in this particular string? We already know P is 0th letter, Y is first, T is second, and so on, N is the 5th letter. Is it even possible to access a negative index for a string? Let's execute and check. Yes, it is possible. If you see, we are not getting any error. In fact, we are getting the exact letters from the string, but this time they are in the reverse order. Minus 1, it is showing N. For minus 2, it is showing O. For minus 3, it is H. For minus 4, it is T. And so on. For minus 6, it is showing P, which is the first letter of the string. Which means, whenever we do minus 1, it accesses the last letter of the string. Minus 2 is second last letter. Minus 3 is third letter from the end. Minus 4 is fourth letter from the end, and so on. This particular indexing is called as negative indexing. Let's see the next concept related to strings. First, let's declare one string variable and let's have some very big value against this variable. Some random character. Let's try to print s of, let's say, 100. We don't know whether we have 100 letters in the string or not. The string looks big enough but may not be big enough to have 100 characters. Let's execute and see what happens. It shows an error which says string index out of range, which means we are trying to access the 100th character in the particular string. But as per the error, it says index out of range, which means the 100th character does not even exist in the given string, due to which computer cannot print it. Now the question is, if we have such a big string, maybe even bigger like this, still the output is index out of range. In case of such a big string, how to figure out exactly how many number of characters are there in that string, so that we will not end up using some index value which is out of range. For that, there is one command called as len, which means length, print of length of s. Let's execute and the output is 36. This number 36 represents the total number of characters in this particular string. Now, as we know, there are 36 characters, which means now we should be able to execute s of 36. What do you think? Will this code execute or still we will get error? Let's see. Still we are getting that same error, string index out of range. But we already calculated that the length is 36. Still it is giving error. Can you tell me why this particular thing is happening? Because if you remember, in Python, the string indexing starts from 0. Due to which, whenever we say there are 36 letters, that means the indexes are from 0 to 35. Let's make it 35 and see whether we are getting the last character of the string or not. Yes, indeed, we are getting the letter F, which is the last letter in that particular string, which is the 35th character, which indicates that we can use the index number which is 1 less than the total length of that particular string. In this case, the length of string is 36. Therefore, the highest possible index is 35. Thank you for watching this lecture. Happy learning.